cis white man.
Ooh.
Me.
20-year-old Isaiah Isaac has been deaf since birth, but his parents and two younger brothers have learned sign language, which helps tell their story of a police car stop in Belleville, New Jersey.
He said it was six cars just surrounding him.
I mean, I didn't know what they was trying to do.
Isaiah's younger brother, Dominique, was the only hearing person inside a Chevy full of six minority men when it was stopped by an unmarked police car on Greylock Parkway as the group drove to a basketball game. Dominique Isaac says their driver was deaf and got out of the car to get his license from the trunk. Isaac claims one officer confronted the driver near the passenger side.
When he slammed him in, that's why I was trying to tell him, he's deaf. It was like this. And then he was like, what's wrong with you? I said, they're deaf.
He was searching one of the kids. He said, look at him shaking. He must have something on him. Never thought he was shaking out of fear.
Isaiah and Dominique's father, a former U.S. Marine, says his hearing son walked home and told him the story. Isaiah showed us how he was frisked by cops who were on patrol because of recent burglaries in the neighborhood, reportedly carried out by three or four black men. Dominique told us he was one of four in the back seat. He was next to his brother.
He told me to call my mother, and the driver did too. When he threw him in, he told me to call my mother. I told them to wait so they don't think I have something in the back. So,
when you say have something, what do you mean?
Like as in like a gun or something.
So my son's saying why he got his hands behind his head being checked. All of the neighbors walking their dog, looking at them, shaking their head like they did something wrong.
Frances Stamps works in a hospital, and her husband is a chef at a school for the disabled. Thomas Isaac said his deaf son was happy that friends from his Trenton School for the Hearing Impaired were visiting.
In the time that he'd get out, this would happen to him. So I was real upset.
Within a half hour of the incident, the father of two of the young men who were in that car, the only hearing person in the vehicle, and his deaf brother, turned up here at the Belleville Police Department to file a complaint.
We don't racial profile and we don't discriminate against handicapped.
Chief Joseph Rotunda told PIX 11 Internal Affairs briefed him on the case.
Well, I think once the investigation is concluded, we will explain to the parents exactly the circumstances of what had happened.
I want my sons and his deaf friends to be able to go, you know, live like normal lives.
Apologize for making a public spectacle out of my kids.
In Belleville, I'm Mary Murphy, PIX 11 News.